I want to get Ben Hansen in here to figure out what's going on here. He's a former FBI agent who also co-hosts the show UFO Witness on Discovery Plus. Ben, I have been waiting with bated breath to get you to weigh in. What are your thoughts?
Well, Ashleigh, the comments from those around the world you just showed are pretty spot on. That's what people are asking, you know, trying to run through the gamut of things. The changing of the color and how it goes black to white and back again, I don't necessarily agree that it means it's changing heat signature. In fact, when we look at thermal images, it's taking a range of values of everything that's in the background. If it's on automatic setting, what it tells me, though, is that it's probably happening in camera. It's not an artifact. Even some of these ardent skeptics are saying it's probably not a smudge. You see how in focus this thing is, right? If it were a smudge, it would probably just be a big blur in the front, and we wouldn't have something that looks like it's happening at a distance.
Yeah, the smudge part is the first thing we could rule out. Some have said it looks eerily reminiscent of guys, you know, flying in jetpacks. And if you have an Instagram feed, at some point you've seen the guys with jetpacks landing on carriers or landing on boats. I mean, they're all very sort of new age. And it does have that kind of feel. But what are your thoughts about that?
Well, I had thought that as well. If you go watch, I think it was just the past year, they were doing these demo runs. You know, contractors have created something. You actually have to kind of stand like Iron Man, very rigid with your arms out to your side. And they have these jets on their arms, on the feet, and they can bring stuff from ship to shore. But this was several years ago. I mean, I don't know when that came into being. Plus, if we're to take the witnesses at face value, they said that these were silent. And also, don't forget, Ashleigh, remember this summer we covered the Peruvian alien story where the witnesses were describing jetpack-like beings that had come down and done things. So I don't really know, but it's very strange.
Strange indeed. Do you, with your background, I asked the same thing of Nick Pope. Do you gravitate towards this being a potential, you know, alien UAP, or do you gravitate towards this being something that might be foreign spycraft and extraordinarily sophisticated and something that we really should be concerned about?
Well, I can say this much. I could probably, give me some time, I could recreate this with a drone. We could dress it up in a ghillie suit. We could fly it, make it look like this, maybe a cluster of balloons, but it would be a very elaborate hoax. And for this to happen in Iraq, and for it not to show up, according to them, in night vision, which does see into the near infrared, so a little bit of that same spectrum, but in the unaided eye, they're not seeing, they're not hearing, it raises some red flags for me that we might be dealing with something very sophisticated, and I would hope that if it's that exotic, it doesn't belong to another country. Because we keep saying this over and over, but we're in trouble if this is something terrestrial that we don't know, maybe more so than if it were extraterrestrial.
What do you make of the transmedium capabilities? And that's a fancy way of saying, you know, through the air with ease, into the water with ease, out of the water with ease. I mean, that's the kind of thing we as, you know, mere humans, so to speak, are not very good at, as we understand anyway, as Americans. We understand, you know, we don't have those capabilities yet.
We don't, to the public's knowledge, especially, taking something that it's supposed to be moving through water and then suddenly take to the air. It takes different propulsions, different lift systems. And this second part of the video where we're told that this was flying over perhaps some sort of lake, when you look at that, you can actually, in my opinion, see what might be a reflection. And that reflection does happen in thermal imaging where, like a mirror or water, you'll get that. So again, it tells me something's happening very close to the water. Even if it wasn't captured on video, you know, I'd have to say it's possible that this thing did exactly what the witnesses said. It came out of the water and then all bets are off. We're not talking about balloons. We're not talking about the drones that the public is aware of.
Next question. Again, with all of your background in studying UAPs, UFOs, the same thing. The concept that this journalist says the acceleration out of the water after 17 minutes underwater was so fast it was unrecordable by any of the technologies that we currently possess, you know, so far that we know we possess. What do you make of that kind of speed? Because I have heard that before. I think with the Tic Tac video, we heard about the naval pilots watching this Tic Tac fly off at a speed that was just unfathomable.
Well, even if you have some of our most advanced underwater, let's say ballistic missiles that take off from a submarine underwater, that's still able to be captured by video to some extent. They're extremely fast, but all that drag and what, you know, the theorists are saying, the drag is what's being displaced. And so for it to go from water to air and that quickly is dealing with things that we don't know how to do.
I have 10 seconds left, but what about the silence from the Pentagon? Does it speak volumes, or should I just not jump to that conclusion?
It's typical. Remember the Tic Tac video, and those videos had the similar thing. It took them years to finally admit it was one of their videos. So I think they got to find out who took this. How did it get leaked out? They may not even know. It's very compartmentalized, and hopefully they do come forward and at least admit it was military footage.
Thank you for watching. Go to NewsNationNow.com to find NewsNation on your television provider. And don't forget to click the red subscribe button below to get more of NewsNation's fact-driven, unbiased coverage.